Hip impingement, or better known as FAI syndrome or femoroacetabular impingement, we're going to simplify it in this video and go through the explanation. So hopefully you get a bit more of a better understanding as to what this problem is without the medical jargon. So let's go. Now, hip impingement, FAI syndrome, femoroacetabular impingement, interchangeably, they're all the same thing. I'm going to break it down on this video to hopefully give you a bit more of a better understanding, a bit of a clearer explanation in regards to what this condition is. And in further videos in the future, we're going to be going through how to manage it, how to treat it, surgery, scans, all of that stuff. So stay tuned for more videos that are going to come. But for now, let's dive into it. So let's strip it right back. The hip joint, we've got a ball and socket, okay? Now, hip impingement is if there is potentially some sort of influence on the mechanics. So if you're moving the hip around normally, ball and socket, you normally move it around with no problems at all. Now, with hip impingement or FAI syndrome, there are two components, two subcategories that we're going to refer to. One of them is called a CAM, C-A-M, so CAM morphology or a CAM impingement. Now, that is when you find it on the ball of the socket. So you've got ball and socket, and you might have this additional little bump that's on the neck of that bone called the femur. In some instances, that can, in certain positions and mechanical places and positions and activities, become a problem at some point. And we're going to be a little bit more specific in a second, but I'm going to just kind of keep it vague for the minute. The other bit is the socket part. So we've got obviously the ball and socket. We've said the CAM is on the ball part, and the pincer, which is another type of impingement, is if there's too much over coverage. So that could be if you have a deeper socket, or if that could be the position of the socket is just slightly tilted, meaning that you get a slight excess coverage. Now, both of these types of impingement, the CAM or the pincer, can be absolutely normal. Let me explain this, right? So people who have hip impingement often age ranges between 25, 35, give or take. So we've got a specific young adult population, often quite athletic and active. Now, if you're presenting with pain of hip impingement in your mid-20s, in your mid-30s, that CAM that I said to you, the little bony bump on the ball part of the ball and socket, develops when you're growing up. So we're talking pre-adolescent years into adolescent years. That's the kind of like 11 to 16. Because bones are growing and developing. A skeletal maturation, whatever you want to refer it to, bones essentially grow up until a certain point, meaning that they've got these things that allow the bones to get longer. Now, those growth plates are only there in those who haven't fully matured yet from a skeletal perspective. That's why CAMs can develop through types of sports. So if you're playing football or soccer or cutting based sports like hockey during those early adolescent years, then it might lead to the development of a CAM, this little bony bump, but that can be absolutely fine. The interesting thing is, we found, and a lot of research has identified, that loads of people who are active, fit, healthy, who do sports and have done throughout their whole lives and have no pain, may have a CAM. Doesn't necessarily mean they're going to get hip pain. So the CAM itself isn't what FAI syndrome is. FAI syndrome requires quite a lot of different components to get that full diagnosis. Now, the pincer is different. Now, the pincer is part of your pelvis because that's part of the socket. Now, that could also be due to developmental factors that could cause to it, genetic, loads of things, maybe potentially even again from a developmental perspective, but it isn't the sports induced response that you get from a CAM. Now, the interesting thing here is for CAMs, we tend to slightly see a bit more of a prevalence towards the male population. And with the pincer, this overcoverage that I mentioned, often tends to be in a female population. That's not exclusive. And also, you can sometimes have a bit of both. Now, this is the interesting thing here, right? The bony bump from the CAM isn't the thing that hurts. The overcoverage from a pincer isn't the thing that hurts. It's actually the impact of the impinging nature of this. And I do this in brackets, you know, if it is impinging at all. But if it is, and that is the problem that we're dealing with, it's often the influence on the labrum. Now, the labrum is almost like the lining of the socket, right? So you've got ball, socket, and then the lining of it that keeps it nice and suction to the joint. And if you tear the labrum as a result of either the CAM or the pincer, then actually sometimes that's when hips can start to become quite problematic. Now, this is where things are even more interesting, because just because you have a labral tear doesn't necessarily mean you're definitely going to have hip pain. Because like I said to you, the CAM, you can find in a pain-free hip. The pincer, you can find in a pain-free hip. And the labral tear you can also find in a pain-free hip. So having these components doesn't necessarily mean you're definitely dealing with FAI syndrome, but in future videos, I'm going to go through in a little bit more detail in regards to like scanning, injections, and from a diagnostic perspective, how to really make sure that we get that right. At the moment, we're just trying to explain what this condition is. Now, over a period of time, if you do have a cam or do have a pincer, and those are the things that are leading to you having a painful hip, then if it's having an influence on the labrum and your labrum becomes torn, then that starts to present with symptoms and pain that are really quite indicative of FAI or hip impingement. And that process, so I guess the progress and the progression of this condition starts to really cause a bit more of a problem. So although you may well have had the, you could argue like the characteristics of it, the fundamental anatomy of it with the cam and the pincer throughout your life, you're only starting to develop symptoms almost like decades after that. And in particular, that's a key thing to consider, especially when people are being told to have surgery to resolve it and reduce it and shave bits of bones off and repair the labrum. You know, that's the thing that we really need to consider, because these factors may well have been there before. So we really need to kind of consider that. So in a bit of summary, we've got ball and socket joint. You've got the cam, which is a bit of a bony bump that might be pressing on a certain area of the hip with certain movements. You've got the pincer, which is an overcoverage. Sometimes that can cause a bit of impingement in certain movements. And the thing that sometimes hurts, if it is going to hurt, is usually the labrum. And that's the thing that we'd normally kind of look into with certain scanning and imaging and from a diagnostic perspective, like I mentioned there. So hope you found that useful. There is a whole series of these videos coming. Scanning, imaging, injections, treatment, physio, exercises, the lot, with loads of other exercises and condition videos coming as well. So it's a new channel. I'd really appreciate your support. Let me know in your comments any questions that you've got, and hope to see you here soon.